Hello guys, in this class we will see about the preparation of urea formaldehyde resin. Okay, so basically we have got two types of plastics guys, thermoplastics and then the thermosetting plastics. Thermoplastics are the one which can be remolded again, so that means it can be given for recycling purpose. For example, if you take this water bottle, it's a kind of thermoplastics which can be remolded. Okay. And thermosetting plastics are the one which cannot be remolded. We cannot mold it again. Okay, we cannot make it into another form. For example, the outer cover of this remote and the switch boxes and all, they are made up of the thermosetting plastics. Okay, which cannot be remolded, and that means which cannot be given for the recycling purpose. Alright, so today's class is about the preparation of urea formaldehyde resin. What kind of resin is this? Okay, thermosetting. Okay, so that means using this resin, thermosetting plastics can be prepared. Alright, so this class is about the theoretical part of the preparation of urea formaldehyde resin. And what is the formula for the urea? Okay, NH2CONH2 is the formula for urea, and formaldehyde is HCH2. So what is required for the preparation of the urea formaldehyde resin? Urea is required, alright, and then formaldehyde is required, and the reaction is going to occur in the presence of sulfuric acid. So concentrated sulfuric acid is required. Okay, so now I am going to discuss with you all about the reactions that is occurring between the urea and formaldehyde in the presence of the sulfuric acid. Okay, only the theoretical portion, and the practical portion will be sent later on. I'm going to see various steps involved in the preparation of urea formaldehyde. This is the formula for urea, NH2C double bond O NH2, and formaldehyde, okay, is HCHO. Formaldehyde is HCHO. Okay, I am writing this urea in this way, that is NH2C double bond O, then NH2. Okay, let me write the formaldehyde like CH2O. So I am writing the formaldehyde as CH2O. So what happens? So this is actually the first step whereby monomethylol urea will be formed. Okay, so just this formaldehyde adds up to the NH2 group. So what happens? NHCH2OH will be formed. Hydrogen from NH2 will shift to oxygen. That's it. Okay. So NHCH2OH will be formed. So remaining part we can write like this. So what is this? This is monomethylol urea. Okay, so next step will be the formation of dimethylol urea. So whereby to this monomethylol urea, one more formaldehyde is added up so that the NH2 group will be converted into NHCH2OH. Okay, this is formaldehyde just adds up to the NH2. So dimethylol urea is formed in the next step. Okay, so first step is the formation of monomethylol urea. One molecule of urea adds to the one molecule of formaldehyde to form monomethylol urea. Okay, so this is again reacted with one molecule of formaldehyde to form dimethylol urea. Monomethylol urea. So this on polymerization will give a linear kind of polymer. Okay, so whereas dimethylol urea on polymerization will give you a kind of cross linked polymer. I am going to tell you how to write the structure for the linear polymer which is prepared from the monomethylol urea, as well as how to write the structure for cross linked polymer which is prepared from the dimethylol urea. Okay, as well as I'll tell you how to write the final product, that is urea formaldehyde resin also. N molecule of monomethylol urea on polymerization will give you linear chain of polymer. Okay, so this is monomethylal urea. This on polymerization. Okay, will give you a linear form of polymer. So I'm going to tell you how to write that linear form of polymer. Just don't write hydrogen from here and OH from here. So this is a kind of condensation polymerization whereby water molecule is removed. Just write NH, C double bond O, NH, CH2 alone. Okay. So I'm writing that NH, C double bond O, NH, CH2 alone. Okay. So this group is getting repeated N time. This is how to write the linear form of the polymer that is resulted from the monomethylal urea on polymerization. So next, if dimethylal urea is taken and then polymerized, okay, so you will get a cross-linked structure. So let me tell you how to write the cross-linked structure of the polymer that is resulted from the dimethylal urea. A simple way of writing the cross-linked polymer is, don't write hydrogen and OH from here as well as hydrogen and OH from here. So this group will be repeated n times. To show the continuation of the polymeric chain, just write put like this. Okay. So this is the simple way of writing cross-linked polymeric chain. Okay. So next I will tell you how to write the final structure of urea formaldehyde residue. So this is actually step 4 by which cross-linked polymer is formed. Okay, the fifth step will be the final formation of urea formaldehyde resin, which is formed by a heating such kind of linear polymer and cross-linked polymer. So this is the structure of the final urea formaldehyde resin. Okay. I'll just tell you how to write the structure in simple way. Now I'm going to tell you how to write the final structure of urea formaldehyde resin. The first step is formation of monomethylal urea. Next step, formation of dimethylal urea. Monomethylal urea on polymerization gives a linear polymer. And dimethylal urea on polymerization gives a cross-linked polymer. And those polymers are again heated to give the final product of urea formaldehyde resin. Okay, now let us write the structure of urea formaldehyde resin. So I'm going to discuss with you how to write the urea formaldehyde resin in the easy way. Okay, put 6 nitrogen like this. And then CH2 between the first 2 nitrogen. Then C double bond O between next 2 nitrogen. So write like this. Now connect these 2 by CH2 group. Okay. After that, the polymer chain continuation should be showed like this. CH2 group, attach CH2 group, and it also continues. Here also attach a CH2 group. Okay, so this is how to write the final structure of urea formaldehyde resin. Hope you all understood the preparation of urea formaldehyde resin. Meet you all in next class.